So how was the rest of your stream, Boti?
I thought you were about to talk to me. I was like, my stream was good. I was just playing Resi 4 Remake.
Yeah, I was wondering, did you stop streaming?
Yeah, I stopped streaming so I can set up to do D&D.
Were you streaming earlier?
Are you going to set that up, or what you going to do with
I didn't get any notifications about that.
I'm thinking I might make you, like, extra small because you're actually a small person.
Helen's also very small.
I won't make you too small. Make you slightly smaller, though.
Make Helly as small as you want.
No. I'm talking about you.
Wait, no. I'm bigger
your
than
character. Helly. Yeah, but you're smaller than Rat Queen.
Yeah.
Rat Queen's cock is huge.
Oh my god.
Rude.
You're crazy. Okay, who's next? Next is Helen.
Some thigh highs on. I was cold. Bright.
Probably
warm.
Quite warm and snuggly.
There's just gray.
Yeah.
Nothing interesting.
Yeah.
I keep muscling with Mother Abigail. To put in Subway sandwiches with her art.
Oh goodness.
I think it's so funny.
I was there for one of those times.
Yeah, how she did it.
Hella's gonna be judging. What? There we go. That works. Perfect. Nope, he's bigger than
him. Yeah, so far I've gotten Goat to do it. I've gotten
Mother was Abigail to do it. I was like,
I didn't know Abby did it.
Yeah, she did it on one of her streams. She like removed it almost immediately after the joke was over.
A little bit of space between y'all.
Was it on the monster with the four arms?
No, it was like way long ago, like months ago. I think it was like a few days after I did the one with Goat.
Helly, make a sound.
But I did. You were there when I was like saying it for the four-armed one.
Helly, make a sound.
The arms are in the right, like perfect positions too. Just like, oops, drop my sandwich.
There we go, that's me. Okay.
Yeah, I'm leaning pretty far back in my chair. That's probably why my mic didn't pick it up.
I was just trying to see exactly where all your stuff was on your character so that I can make sure that it's not overlapping Guild's face.
Oh.
My face.
It doesn't need to be there.
Your face.
Let's give my town people some problems.
Let's see. Yeah. All five players are here already.
I thought this lady.
Who's doing a recap?
I want that inspiration, but I don't remember what happened, so.
Not much happened, I'll tell you that.
What are you
right
talking
now.
About? Lots happened. Lots happened.
Let me check. Does anyone not have inspiration?
I don't.
Oh, you don't
I still have mine.
Oh, I don't. You can be
Hold up, hey Hyde, where's my birthday cake?
When was your birthday?
It was March 9th.
All right.
The whole week of me doing a bunch of nonsense streaming, yeah.
Shit. I'll make you one later.
Yeah, I was like, I want birthday cake. Kelsa still has his. I want mine.
Rat Queen still has hers too.
What are y'all talking about?
Well, for your birthday, you get birthday cake.
You get a special birthday cake card.
Yeah.
I'm like, so weird.
It is weird, but that's, yeah. It's the land of D&D. Anything can happen.
I mean, I guess. My birthday was in
February. As I'm sitting here playing Cult of the Lamb while I wait for everyone to...
A bit.
I bet I could probably play both. I want this house. Give it to me.
I'm already ready.
I just deny someone from eating poo because they wanted to eat it. I was like, no. I use that for my plants. Eat normal food like normal people.
Okay, sure.
I guess one of us gotta do the recap. You want me to do it?
We wandered around some more, and then we saw an Illithid, and he charmed Alea, and then we had to fight the silly boy. And Alea got caught in a net and then was free and from the charm. And then we killed the silly boy. Alea got a cloak. We did some more investigating. We saw a puzzle and didn't solve it. And we went into this library here and Umreva and the silly culty boy were talking. She said hello and just gave us the key. And then they both went through that door to the right. And then we investigated the library. Oryx was disgusted to find out that it is just full of nothing but just housewife novels.
Took a few of them.
So of course I've taken a few. And then before we could investigate this room on the right with all the plamnits, a monster came out of the room in the north. And then we had to start running. And then the monster got hurt and angry and turned into a dragon. And now we're running from the dragon, but my spear made me hang back and give him a poke. Now the dragon's scared of me, and I'm gonna bully it a couple turns before we go back to running. And that's what we did last week.
Well, I guess I should keep my word and make my drinkies.
Drinkies.
It's drinkies. I got Hawaiian punch and juice. 100% juice.
Got the chase music.
Technically 40%. That's at the point though. What?
Got the chase music. Treat,
okay.
I guess.
Potato juice.
It is potato juice. Yes. I'll have a Sour Patch Bunny.
All right, Dungeon Master. What do we do?
Bunny eating bunnies.
Give me just a second. Boom.
I got the chase music on. But I should really change it to the Benny Hill music.
You mean Yakety Sax?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I get that. Yeah.
What you mentioned on the go?
Burrito.
And you know, sure.
I got two. I got a burrito for you. Just put it right to the mic. Here you go.
No, let's wait, stop.
OMG, sus. Sus? Y'all being sus over here?
No, I'm just
waiting. He does this to me all the time.
Well, they want me to share, and I'll share. I'll immediately share. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. No comments. Okay, well, I did comment, but like, no more comments.
It's all good.
My stupid beast.
I love my chapstick. It's vanilla scented, and it smells so good. It makes me want cake. Weeble, what is that emote?
Alexa, what's the emote be at 6 a.m.?
Comfy thighs. Thigh highs. Nice.
I got thigh highs.
There we go. Got you your birthday cake.
Heck yeah.
There you go, baby.
Now birthday
you
know cake.
I can't wear thigh highs.
Alrighty.
You stealing my chapstick? I just put it on.
That's what you buy. But you wanted to kiss me before I left the
room. Lady.
Ah.
It's you're usually her keeper anyways. I'm putting you in charge of Kelta's,
yeah.
Token.
I had control all last week.
Okay.
Yeah, I still haven't turned that off.
Nice thought.
Yeah, I just don't mess with it.
Alrighty. So, let's see here. It is currently Shinx's turn. So, Shinx.
First up on table, Deuce.
I thought we finished out the round before we left.
Yeah.
Oh, shit, that's right. Hold on. Fixing my notes here. Alrighty. So, we'll go with Aaliyah.
Oops, I put a little bit too much. It's fine.
I think that would be a...
half potato juice.
Ooh. Ooh.
15 feet. Alright, it's gonna be Aether's turn.
Are we continuing to run, or what are we doing?
Well, that's up to you.
We're already upstairs.
Okay.
Yep, Obix,
You said only 15, right?
Yeah, 15 feet.
There we go.
3 blocks. Alright, Zesh. Jesus. Alright, go ahead and roll for damage. Because that'll definitely fucking hit.
Bullying the dragon.
You know what's funny? I just said that this is going to hit hard, but that might hit hard too. Talking about my drinky drink.
Let me try clicking that again.
Should just let you click on the...
I tried that. Would you like to try?
Yeah. Oh, it's asking what you're casting at what level?
Ah, if that's a pop-up in the middle of the screen, I won't be able to see it.
I thought you were using your newer laptop.
No. Haven't been, because yeah, things soon.
Shit, I don't know how to move it for you.
So
go ahead, just tell me what level you want to cast it at.
Let me see. It's only 1d6 for every level above first, so first level.
Alright. Jesus.
That's all a right. Lot of damage.
So we're just doubling the first number, which is 20, so it goes up to 40. And he will be taking 80.
Because it's brave damage.
Yep.
That's a lot of damage. Alright.
Is that your turn? Or do you want to use your movement?
Oh, sorry.
I thought we were choosing between action or movement.
I'm gonna move this over here.
Were we? But, I can't quite remember.
Yeah, that's how you had been ruling.
Right,
it.
I didn't write it down in my notes.
I also have my spiritual weapon.
Yep, that's a bonus action.
So, I forget, how does it attack again?
Spiritual weapon, hold on. Boom. Pulling up your spell list. Spiritual weapon. So, it is going to use a spell attack, which is... Go ahead and roll me a d20.
And then we add my casting mod and maybe proficiency.
Yes, it would be your wisdom, so +3, +2, so 5. So 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 14. Yeah, that's unfortunately going to miss.
Oh well.
Alrighty. And it is now Kenku time.
No, it's a baby, not a Kenku.
I'm running away.
If you're moving past Zesh, the furthest you'd be able to get is right there.
Okay.
Alright, it is now Big Boy's turn. Boop. And boop. That is his turn. As he flees away further from the spear. And we're back to Aaliyah.
No poison damage?
Oh, hold on.
Yeah, he was moving through them thorns.
What was the damage for the poison? Miss Merberberb, can you tell me what the damage was? What the dice were?
I will look. Oh heck, I don't know.
On the sheet, it should say on the card. Let's go to item cards.
Okay, I'm going.
And we're gonna pull that up here. Here we go. 2d4 every 5 feet. Alright, so he just went 15 feet. So that's 2d4. My first one's going to be 4, 5, 6, 7 damage, poison. The second one's going to be 5 damage, poison. It's even now up to 12 points of poison damage.
Okay.
Every five feet that he moved out. Which he moved out 10. We're ready, and yeah, it's back to Aaliyah.
1, 2, 3.
Alright. Aether.
Yep. I'm done.
All right. Is back to Shink.
Isn't it Zesh?
Well, it's Shink's ahead of Zesh now, in the order.
Okay.
Yeah, it's better this way so that we aren't constantly having to walk past each other. It's slowing us down.
Yeah, that's why I decided, depending on how close you are to the exit, is who gets to go first.
And now it's back to Zesh.
Is the boy still within 60 feet? I can't tell.
We got a snap to center. Boop. He is still within 60 feet, yes.
Then I'm gonna cast Sacred Flame.
Alrighty. Go ahead and cast that for me. Boom. Alright, he needs to make a spell save DC, which is dexterity of 13.
Probably a bad idea to be mixing this with this juice. But whatever.
Alright, he got 17 plus 4, that will pass. He will not be taking any radiant damage.
Dang. Okay, and then I can move my weapon up to 20 feet, so I'm gonna move it 20 feet closer.
Wrong thingy. Oh, come on. Okay, so it's 10. Pow. Alrighty. Big boy's turn.
That's 20 feet.
Oh god.
Yeah, it moves 20 feet closer and can make an attack.
Well, it was right here. And
so, assuming the dragon boy only moved 15, it should be able to hit him again.
Yep. Well, his 15 is a bit bigger than your 15.
That's not how numbers work.
It's based on the size of the creature.
Ow.
But yeah, you are still close enough to hit him.
Okay, so that's another d20.
Thank you for the pet.
Yeah, that's not gonna hit.
That will unfortunately miss. It's his turn.
Yeah, run time.
Alright, he still hasn't broken from the fear. He is getting as far back as the back wall, and he can't move any further because of the constraints of the hall.
And he was somehow able to squeeze into the one that chases us.
Well, he hadn't transformed into that point. This one, however, is just big enough for him to squeeze his wings in through, because the ceiling is higher.
Mm-hmm.
But with this room right here, the ceiling is much lower, as it's just made for people size.
Are we not people size?
No. Alright, so Aaliyah's going up the stairs. Aether!
What happened? What? Oh,
it's your turn.
Movement, right.
It's your turn.
Y'all move! Alrighty.
Oh my god.
And now it's Kanku time.
Kanku time. Kanku time.
Alright, Zesh.
The sus butt? Oh my god.
I'm running. One. Two. Three.
How far away can you be from that spiritual weapon?
I was wondering about that, and
okay,
the
it's
way
still
I
within
read
60
it,
feet.
Yeah. Like, it says it has a range of 60 feet, but in the spell description, it never mentions how far away it's allowed to be.
Well, usually the range and how far away you're supposed to be is generally treated as the same thing.
Yeah, so I'm gonna move it closer and attack again.
Alrighty. We're gonna come over here. God damn it. that, and that will unfortunately miss again.
Nice. This is not one to get hit.
All right, Aether, going up the stairs. Bop. Shink.
Oh, I vanished.
Zesh.
One.
Can't believe he hasn't succeeded his fucking save for fear yet.
He's a scaredy boy.
He's so spooked.
God damn it. Alright, Shink.
They fail again.
Zesh.
One, two, three.
One sucky chase if he can't even stop fear.
It's like being so scared. It's
so spooky. Oh, I thought you were gonna use your bonus action. Oh wait, no, your spear would be moving a lot closer to you now.
Yeah.
Fuck.
That's why I couldn't use it last time.
Alright, there we go. Yeah. Poop already. Finally, yes. You rolled a 17 again.
And now they're gone.
And he's entering into the thorns again.
Yep.
Well, see,
which are
right.
The thorns are centered here, I believe.
Yes. I
got moved with the weapon.
And he will be taking 4 poison damage. All right, back to you, Zesh.
Right. That's okay.
Before I move, I'm gonna make a swing.
Go ahead. 17 plus 5. Yeah, that'll hit.
Wow. Nice. Unbelievable, this boy.
And then that's.
Dab, dab.
I forget. I think it's a d8.
So do 1d8 plus 5. Plus whatever number it has you doing. I'm pretty sure. Pretty sure that's how it works. Reading it there with you. 1d8 plus your spellcasting modifier. Yeah, so it would be 1d8 plus 5. And you can actually do that when you're sitting. Yeah, there you go. 13. There we go. What type damage was it?
Force damage on
force
spirit
damage.
Virtual weapon.
Oh, force damage. Rare. Alrighty.
And then I'm going to
three blocks of movement.
1, 2, 3.
What a dickhole. What a dumbass.
Yep,
and he takes the thorns damage.
Yep, I gotta take give me a second. He takes 4 poison. And he takes 6 poison. 4 poison and 6 poison. 10 poison total. Alright. You can go ahead and go up the stairs.
Gonna swing first.
Gonna swing first. Go ahead. I should probably be over here.
What sort of lamp uses batteries?
13 plus 5. 13, 14, 15, 16. 16 will miss.
Nope, that was not my roll. This is my roll.
12, 12, 12 will miss.
Yeah.
All right.
Going up the stairs.
Give me just a second. Copy. Pasta.
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 Pasta, pasta, put it in a bowl.
Sounds like an old parrot.
Pasta, rat, pasta.
Go home, you drunk.
What the hell?
Come on.
I'm enjoying my time home.
Mom! Good job.
Yeah. Come on, roll 20, work with me here.
You said no.
It's 7.
What piggy bank breaks completely, perfectly in half. None do that.
Uh-oh, I'm breaking shit.
Of course you want a butt hide.
Alright, stop random clicking. There we go.
Click, 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 click.
Alright, you are no longer fettered by the 15-foot movement. I'm going to need a perception check from Zesh, though.
Okie dokie.
Looks like we're...
Perception 8. Don't worry, you needed at least a 6 to pass. You will all hear a earth-shakingly loud roar coming from this dragon. Zesh will look over her shoulder down the stairs in time to see black flames flooding the staircase. They are climbing up the stairs.
Everyone move.
All right. Come along. Yes. Come along then. Hello.
And away
run
we go.
Faster.
Hello.
Hey.
Zesh, yeah, just stick it in my head, dragon. Yeah. You got it.
Hell, we're just speeding along.
All right, as soon as you get through the threshold of this door, Zesh, this top of the stairs is currently being swallowed by the flames, and they are spreading further.
It just works.
Anything they touch is aging at a rapid rate, including the very rock walls that surround you.
Wait, let's wait for the party. Come along. Friends!
Chink!
Chink! Uh-oh. Dash! Use your dash action!
Oh, no, Requiem? Oh, okay. I was like, oh no, did she disconnect again?
No, I was drawing fire.
Oh, you were drawing fire.
You're drawing the fire for us, thank that. You. Fancy.
Alright, fire is now spreading there. Dive suck ass compared to that. Why is mine less spiky? I did spiky movements.
Come along, friends. Obex, let's go.
Get the fuck out of here.
Well, then let's go.
Let's go.
Well, you all begin hearing the cracking and splashing as several of these cases behind you all begin breaking.
So this is why we can't come back here after. Very well.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let me go up the stairs.
I need yet another perception check, this time from whoever's at the front of the party.
Crap.
Heller?
It's Helly. Hold on.
Perception
check. Oh, there we go.
I worry. You don't have a way to teleport out of here.
Let's see.
I like how Hungry Boy is burying himself.
Huh?
Oh yeah, he's burying himself with all this metal and shit, yeah.
Oh yeah.
That should be it.
Me thinks he's just a thing.
Nine, nope, you're a little too distracted by running for your life to notice.
Oh no.
To notice what?
Aether, give me a perception check.
Okay.
You're pretty much in the same position as Helly.
Perception? Okay. Are you serious?
Aether, you are as concerned as Helly to just get the fuck out of here.
When we get out, can you at least tell us what it was?
You two maybe begin ascending the stairs.
Oh no.
Yeah, we're ascending the stairs. Let's go.
This can't be good. Helly?
Yeah.
You want to go first, or you want me to go first?
I guess I'll move it to the stairs.
Come along, Obex. Dear old friend.
Alright, Shink and Obex will both make perception rolls. And where did I put Obix's? There it is.
Perceptual. Natural 20.
Dang it.
Okay, I don't think Obix needs to make one.
One person that can perceive everything.
As you are fleeing with the rest of your party, Shink, you happen to look towards the ruined staircase, seeing black flames creep between the stones that are currently collapsed within it. The floor under your feet has also begun to crack and wither.
It's just going through everything. My gods.
That's not good.
Okay, let's go, go, go.
Yeah, right. The floor.
Obex, go.
What happened? Oh.
Everybody Obex. Else, come on.
Give me a second. Hey, someone's going crazy in my chat.
Come along. Wait. I patiently waited for the party.
Sorry, Zesh. Aaliyah was attempting to meld into the fucking stonework.
Didn't want to juggle the tokens just to move them.
I know, it's okay. Alrighty. Booping. Alrighty. And there we go. Alrighty. You all made it out.
Is the fire still coming, or?
Unfortunately, the fire has seemingly stopped spreading past the entrance. It does still seem to go a little further than the entrance, but due to the sheer volume of stone that you hear cracking and crumbling behind you, it's likely the flames are being eddied by all the falling rock and dust.
Oh, see myself. There we go.
You'll find yourselves back in the familiar caves of the Underdark.
Wait. Run away!
Give you back.
Bye, Bron.
I was getting music done. I'm so.
Are you back to using the Underdark one?
Yes, I'm using.
Okay.
Generic.
I got Underdark music.
Yeah, I got generic dungeon right now. The Underdark one. I can easily.
Yeah. The Underdark one's the one for this area.
I don't have Underdark one. I have Tavern music.
If you scroll up in D&D chat, Underdark is the first song.
Sorry. I keep getting freaked out. Because someone in chat is freaking me out. What are you doing? Damn it! They just got me a mouse pad. They got me a cat palm mouse pad.
Oh, that's cute.
Right. Who's at the front? Oh.
Me.
That was a beautiful.
I mean.
That was a bit of a run.
Need either Shink or Brawn. I suppose Obix could do it as well. Give me perception checks.
Come on, Aether.
She's just like sitting on me.
Music.
I did not mean to move it.
What is that?
I Perception?
Right. What is
Perception.
What is this? What is this?
You don't know because everybody else is checking perception yet.
Oh.
It's too small.
Well, I guess I got it.
Oh, goddamn it. What is with you guys getting nat 20s on perception checks? Bron, you will see a familiar white raven. It is currently perched atop a large little stone plateau, overlooking you all.
Hello? Hello, dear friend. How are you?
See the bird kind of just like cock its head to the side.
Very peculiar that you're down here, white raven.
Whose was it? Was it the lady's? I don't think it was. I don't think she had a bird. Is it the wizard guy? Blind guy? Is he watching us? That'd be rude.
It's what?
Invasion of privacy.
I can't remember. I think it's the wizard.
Heckin' rude. He hot though. He's still hot. I'll be right back.
The raven will open its little beak, and out from it, it will come the familiar voice of the storekeeper you all met previously.
Yes,
at the magic item shop.
The blind one.
Mm-hmm. Oh, well now, I hadn't thought to meet you friends here. I was sending my little friend here to meet a Madame Umreva who had plans on selling some more magical items to me. However, I believe I noticed that her compound has collapsed.
Her son got really angry.
Her son.
The business fell in on itself.
Oh, that is
a
shame.
Yeah, he wanted to eat us, and we got a little too far away.
Well, it's always a shame to lose someone who's able to get me more magic items for the shop. But I still have other purveyors, so nothing lost too much, I suppose. I will let you all know that I am currently stationed up in Red Larch.
I don't trust this guy no more. He's trying to do business with the lady. No,
I mean,
Joel, I swear to God, Joel, chill out.
Actually, I do have some armor that I'd be willing to sell you.
Oh, I shall keep my hopes in line for when you come visit that. And with...
When our troubles meet, we will see what we can sell you.
Quite. With that, the raven will kind of flip in a little sparkle of glitter almost as it just ceases to be.
Goodness.
Interesting. Alright. Okay. That's weird.
You're weird.
Okay. You're playing both roles, but
I've got to. I
you
feel like he
to.
Would comment.
I was about to comment as
okay.
Always.
Go ahead.
Fucking weird birds.
Ooh, that's
my
just magic. Come on,
y'all are weird for talking to a bird.
We've been talking to a giant one this whole time.
That's a.
Come along, Aether.
I had to give someone a special role because they deserve it.
Oh, I do deserve a special role, thank you.
You already are a VIP.
I want more.
Do you want a cinnamon roll?
More.
Do you want a cinnamon roll? Is that what you want? All right, everybody, come on over. We're having breakfast.
I want one.
Come over. We'll have breakfast.
And cinnamon roll.
And then we'll.
Oh, I forgot
Saturday
to get stuff for cinnamon
cartoons.
Rolls.
We'll watch Saturday morning cartoons.
Yeah, orange. For
middle of Wednesday night.
Cinnamon rolls are delicious.
Apparently, there's strawberry ones. I found a recipe for strawberry ones.
I like the orange one, but the strawberry ones are pretty good too.
After a few more hours of travel, you all find yourself back at the entrance of the cave. The sun has gone down. Outside
of the cave, it takes dark. Hours. Goodness.
Well, that was a bit of a trip. Everybody okay? Heli? Shink?
Zesh, you okay? You were down there for quite some time. Are you hurt?
I bullied a dragon.
she did bully a dragon.
Goodness. I've never seen anybody stare death right in the face and smile at it like that.
Me and Stabby Boy made him scared.
Oh, you frightened the dragon. Sounds lovely. There was a bard here, he'd make a story of it for the century.
Why don't you try? I want to hear it.
I'm not a seducer.
A bard's more likely to try to seduce the dragon rather than sing about it.
I want to hear the song. Come on.
Shink,
what are you doing?
Shink is trying to give him the
what? The what thing?
The key.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I take the key.
You're just gonna sit on him?
Are you adding the key to the handy haversack? Alright, don't forget to put it in there on the item table thing.
The two short people are now pigs.
It is...
Jewel.
Holt's magic key.
Holt's magic key.
I mean, it has an actual name. We actually like. I'm pretty sure I put it in item cards, didn't I?
Yeah.
It is straight up just called Holt's magic key.
Let me get my D&D notebook out. Give me a second.
I was like, did I give it a fancier name? Nope. I think it's actually called an extra planar key, but I just called it Holt's magic key because lore wise he made it.
Let's see, where is that in the item card?
I just had a random thought. Holt's magic pantaloons.
I mean, he's probably got magic pantaloons, but you're likely not gonna see him under those robes.
Holt's magic key.
It's not pointing. I can't make a joke.
No, I mean, he's just got some like basic flesh on him to hide him from being seen as an actual bony lich.
Thank you very much, my good friend. Let us go, Obix.
I'm not gonna make that joke.
Obix is still kind of grumbling over there.
Well, dear friend, what's your plan?
Bird. Well. You all say you've run into these bastards with the black cloaks before, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Multiple times,
huh? They're always causing trouble.
And Madame Onbreva seem to know you all. So I'm thinking if I stick with you, I got another shot at them.
Yep. Oh.
Yeah. Probably.
We'd love to have you accompany us.
We'd love
to. I'll go as far as until my leads go cold. And then you're on your own.
Yep.
Fair.
Sounds good.
Let's go forward then.
Temporary companions. Yes. Glad to have you here.
Oh, Chink. Please don't go off the map. I need to copy paste.
No, Chink will just get left behind.
No.
Oh, well. Stop being cute. I want
to
cuddle you.
No, she's too adorable to not be cute.
Yeah, but you'd be too cute, and then I'm going to actually shrink her, put her in my pocket, and feed her Skittles.
Helly's pretty cute, too.
Mm-hmm.
Back to Uluvin.
Alright.
Helly is cute.
What music do you want me to play?
That's a good question. Let me pull it up right now. Boom. 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 Spotify. Boom.
Rat Stooky.
No.
Yeah. Cute Squeaky. you know what? I'm gonna shrink you down and I'm gonna put you right in between all of my stuffed animals and you'll look just like them.
Wow.
And be cozy.
Dark.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Let's see.
Give me just a second. I'm sure there's some
nice
one somewhere around here.
Somewhat.
Alrighty, so it's gonna be cities and villages. This is the closest one until we move. Well, we're not going to be here in this area long unless you all decide to stay in the village. So, back to this. God damn it.
I've got some ambience, countryside ambience playing.
There we go. It's in D&D chat.
What? Oh, okay.
And you are all free to move.
It's kind of loud.
It is.
Turn your volume down.
I am turning it down. Don't be rude. I kick a butt. I'll make you get eaten by the mimic. That's on my screen. Because I can.
Alright.
Mm-hmm. I like that boulder. That's a nice boulder.
Which way are we going again?
Well, let's look at the... I thought we were going up north.
Yeah, just checking.
Yes.
Yeah, this way was to Wormford.
I remember there being a place to camp that way.
And it's getting dark. Shin, come along, Shin. Such a quiet bird today.
Shin, I got shiny stuff.
What wonderful plumage.
I was about to be like, where the fuck did Shin go? And all the way until she hasn't moved.
A hind, wait, okay. You want an actual hydrate, or you want a dehydrate?
Sorry.
No problem.
It's okay, Kitty. It's okay.
It's okay, Squeaky. It's okay.
Squeaky what?
I thought you said it's okay, Squeaky. It's okay.
Oh. A hydrate? Okay. I'll drink some water. Technically, the dehydrate costs more points. Technically. Also has a 10-minute cooldown.
Okay.
Alright.
He has knobs. Ooh, what you got?
You find yourselves back at the rest stop.
Oh, yeah?
I don't trust that fish not to come back.
Well, it's either this or we camp further up the road. It's up to you.
I don't know, Darren.
What?
Shouldn't move so much during the night.
She's gonna see us anywhere, so it doesn't actually matter where we go.
Hey.
I'm gonna walk over this.
I always leave Ellie alone.
Oh, I was just wondering if you wanted to cook something. We could cook something.
I gathered extra rations.
She immediately just went straight for the tent.
Fine.
Check Discord. Oh god. Oh, it's okay. Okay.
Goblin and Aaliyah should share a tent.
Ow.
What?
Oh god, which chat?
Wait, what?
What did you do? Okay, it's not that one, so I do need to look at that later. It's not that, is it this? Mm. Yeah. You know, I have a food channel, right? It's called Heckin' Noms.
If y'all want to rest, I can take first watch.
Are you sure?
I was thinking we should make some food first, and then we can definitely do that. Let's make a meal, and then we can make sure that we're all good.
Oh god, that's 5, 10, 15...
Billy seems to really like cooking, so I would let let's see what she can make.
Joel?
Hallie just brings out her book and says Dorito.
Unfortunately, nothing happens, as you've already used it that day before, and a new dawn has not yet risen.
Oh, that's $45. Calm down. You trying to do what?
A Dorito didn't work. A magical book of making food didn't work.
Only works once a day.
I got extra rations if we want some. Standing in the fire.
Obix is going to pull out one of his rations and dump it into the pot with some water from his water skin. Along with a lump of salt.
Worth every cent. Thank you, Joel. You're awesome.
Would you like to maybe, I don't know. I'm just trying to see if Hallie wants to cook. If Hallie doesn't want to cook, I'm not going to force her.
Oh, no. I don't really have anything on me to cook.
Cook our rations. That's about it.
I got 5 extra ones that I picked up at the place.
Yeah, I guess I could cook the rations.
Well, Obix has already beaten you to the punch, as he has just cooked you a pretty good stew.
With
dried meats that he put into the water to bubble, as well as some salt.
Dang, Obix.
Dang.
Goodness. Yeah, apparently, yeah, he got a 24, and pretty good job.
Nice.
Good job, Obix.
This will not give you guys any bonus hit points, unfortunately. As this is just a basic meal to fill you up before bed.
For the Pathfinder game that Ellie playing in. Ooh! Oh,
well, goodness gracious. Seems we survived that encounter. Let's make sure we keep doing that.
Let's try not to fuck with any more dragons.
That'd be
we got out of
good.
There
good idea.
Relatively fine, so, you know. I think we're doing pretty good. I guess. Good night, everyone.
What?
Bron will get up, and he will go.
Obix.
Hallie's gonna go sleep in this tent and fall it run.
Obix is taking first watch. Who is taking second watch and who is taking third watch?
I'll take second.
I'll take third.
Alrighty, everybody go ahead and put your health back to full, refill your spell slots if you got them, and level up.
Level up.
Don't you have to level up for me since I really can't do it?
Oh, correct.
I don't know how to do that.
And also mine.
Because my rolls are stupid.
That's been forever.
Give me just a moment.
It's only level 5. It's not like we get anything big. I don't think it is.
Level 5, you say?
I think we're level 5, yeah.
And a goblin?
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
Silly.
I get one of the fun spells now.
Next time I play D&D, I want to play a herring gun. Okay. I'm bunnies. I didn't know they existed.
Artificer.
Oh.
Alrighty. Roll me a D8, Heli.
Okay.
Ow. Oh, my jaw.
Oh, nice. Ooh. You rolled max for your health gain. You got 8 extra health points on this level up, so you're at 28.
Goodness gracious, that's such low health. Protect Heli.
Yeah, why? Hold on. Yeah, hold on. One second.
What can I do?
Spell slot.
Should've been 8 plus 3. Yeah, okay. That's in line. Artificers are pretty squishy.
I'm sorry, I'm squishy.
It's not your fault. Level 5. You get your Artificer Specialist feature.
What the hell is that?
Yours is, what was your, what is yours again? You're an artillerist. So at 5th level, you gain Scorching Ray and Shatter to your spell lists.
Cool, yeah.
As well as Arcane Firearm.
My god.
You know how to turn a wand, staff, or rod into an arcane firearm, a conduit for your destructive spells. You can use a woodcarver's tool to carve special sigils into a wand, staff, or rod, and thereby turn it into your arcane firearm. The sigils disappear from the object if you later carve them on a different item. Otherwise, they last indefinitely. You can use it as your spellcasting focus. When you cast an artificer spell through the firearm, roll a d8, and you gain a bonus to one of the spell's damage rolls equal to the number rolled. Holy shit. That's actually really good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, let me go.
Paper and a paper. Fancy.
I'm not a tracker.
Alright, hold on 1 second as I pull up stuff. Oh, Jesus, you got that.
How was my roll?
You press, average. Definitely, yep. Go with average.
Figured.
Bills. A level 3 spell slots.
Yeah.
Okay, so you know four. Why is this doing this?
Would Zesh like the silver choker?
Oh, right.
Isn't that a cursed item?
I don't think it's cursed. I think it's just a spider choker. That's it.
Yeah, I think it's just a choker.
I thought it was cursed by something.
Who knows? Any third level spells y'all would recommend?
I don't know. For cleric, I have no idea.
I mean, not a avid D&D player all the time. Don't look into D&D unless I'm playing D&D.
Oh! There's a fun spell.
I think I might get two summon.
Damn it.
Yeah, I think I'll get Tiny Servant and Summon Fae.
Well, I guess I've got to take that one.
You don't have to take anything.
Oh no, there's one that I really should be taking.
Can I step, step? No, I can't.
What is this? Roll.
Oh, I can't step step.
Roll for HP?
Yeah. You're rolling for HP.
HP Lovecraft, oh my god.
Oh,
my god.
Ah. I shouldn't have rolled.
Press average. If you roll under average, just go with average.
Okay.
What y'all doing?
Leveling up, something?
I suppose I'm gonna grab remove curse.
How are you doing the level up?
I'm leveling up for you right now, Helly. Give me just a second.
Okay. I'm just playing my game.
For you, Aether, on your character sheet, right next to your right next to your class and level, it has a little red button you can press that has a little anvil and a hammer. Mm-hmm. You'll click on that.
Uh-huh.
And then you'll just go through that.
Okay.
So you'll just press roll for HP. Alright, go ahead and press average. I believe you're choosing another martial archetype now.
Okay. I thought I already did champion, though.
Oh, ignore that then. You just get an extra attack. Just hit next.
Hmm.
And back to Heli. Hold on 1 second, Heli. I'm almost done. God damn it, I need to stop doing that.
Are you kidding me? Ow.
I've got 44 hit points.
Oh my
I feel like I'm a pretty strong wizard. Pretty powerful.
No, I'm just a baby man.
No, I'm a big man. How dare
you? You've been told long.
So I can't choose any feats or anything?
Probably not this level.
Oh.
Yeah, you can only choose a feat if it's on a level that you gain,
ability score.
Ability scores, yeah. Because you choose whether to...
Yeah, you have to choose between whether you want the ability score improvement or a feat.
Hmm. Okay.
Which, it goes pretty good. Like, if you think you've got enough stats and certain points and certain stats and how you want them, then you can go with a feat instead of adding to them.
Transmutation.
Because I'm good at words.
Yes, until 1 minute.
What is English?
Range. Touch.
Scorching Ray.
Touch.
Pretty sure it's a conjuration, right? Scorching Ray is an evocation. I'm a dumbass.
Duration is 8 hours.
Yeah. Evocation makes sense because you're using an element to just produce an effect.
I already said I was a dumbass, you don't need to rub it in my face.
I'm sorry.
Yes, just in case. Alright, there we go. Done. And also, tiny servants from Xanathar's Guide to Everything, by the way.
So just... all I got was a level up on health? Cool.
You'd have to check Rune Knight. To see if you get anything at 5th level.
Yeah. Which you usually do. Give me just a second, I'll help you out there.
I have one thing that I couldn't add using the character mancer.
Ah! What? Why scream?
You should be able to copy paste it if you're able
no
to.
No loaded dice. Behave.
Copy paste.
Oh my god. No more the dice.
I have some pretty decent real dice, but I can't roll these for anything.
Summon or summon.
I've got really pretty sparkly dice.
It's sparkly. It's got a little unicorn on it.
I think it's transmutation again. Conjuration. Oh. All right.
It's so sparkly. That's good.
One action. Oh, yeah.
Real. It's got red.
Oh, you got one more week.
One more week, you can do it.
And one more.
Camera, come on, man.
Range 90 feet.
Got a red.
I believe in you, right? I'm gonna get the biggest rack of ribs after.
Oh, nice.
They're pretty. Why you what? What's the arrow? I'm very confused. You're the badge? You deserve it. You deserve that badge.
Dang it.
You've been incredibly kind.
That is so irritating. Sorry.
No problem.
Copy, and then we will put it into my spells.
Just don't do it again. I'm kidding.
Oh, God. I'm still very confused as to what's happening, but okay.
I put at higher levels the actual, like, stat blocks for them. So, for these Tiny Servant and the Summon Fae.
Alright, Telly, you are pretty much leveled up.
I like how this moves.
Congratulations.
Not just this. Whenever I do that.
Okay, either. Yours was, Rune Knight, right?
Yeah. This is silly.
Okay, fighter.
Yep. No, no die! You come back here.
I have leveled.
Okay, you gotta wait till your 7th level to get something else from Rune Knight.
Yeah.
Hackers.
I'm gonna get some snacks.
Snacky. Okay, this is a good time to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I just go next.
Let's see, let me just double check for you. Yep, all you do is next. All you got was extra attack.
Hey, that's still in good. Health. Extra attack is good.
In health. Yeah. I've got quite a bit of health now. Yeah. I mean, I had quite a bit of health last one, but I got a bit of health.
Well, you're a melee class, so you typically have more health than everybody else.
Yeah, then we gotta go through a dungeon and actually, like, use our abilities.
58. Okay, so I apply changes, and that's it.
Oh, let's see here. I'll wait to tell you as soon as it happens. Zesh.
Do I just put...
I'm gonna pull you into whispers real quick.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, apply changes, bud. Yeah.
Yeah, apply changes.
Goodness. Thank you, goat.
You're welcome. I'm trying to help. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Why are you apologizing?
I'm so sorry.
You don't need to apologize. You know what? Since I am drinking juice. Totally drinking juice. I'm going to take a quick restroom break. 100% juice. It is potato juice. Mm-hmm. Potato juice. That's what it is. Yep. 100%. I'll be back.
There's someone sick.
Baby.
That's right, someone wanted to make decorations.
That tiny servant is silly.
We're back. Yeah.
Tiny servant is silly. I picked it.
I know a lot of blue does use those to trigger traps.
Oh no, no, he can be our watch, our little watcher.
Are you still adding spells and stuff to your list, Zesh?
I believe I've attached Vampiric Touch correctly.
Yes, looks like it.
Oh my god.
Oh, whoops, sorry. Wrong turn. There we go. Core. Vampiric Touch is an attack, right?
I think so.
Then you have not done it correctly. We'll fix that in a bit, though.
Well, all I know is how to add the description and the stuff on the spell part of the list.
Yeah, I got it. Don't worry about it. I got you. I'm just going to fix something real quick. Certain something's been updated. You might want to check that out at some point.
Me?
Your face.
Oh, my face. I'll have to update my PNG. You got it.
Oh, you're gonna have to update somebody's PNG.
Oh, no.
Well, less of somebody and more of something.
Yeah.
More boobage.
It's a good thing you made that a separate section.
Oh, casting its wisdom. Yeah, you already got that there.
I'll be right back. Hey, boop.
I'm also gonna be right back.
Boop.
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 What about the boop?
Nah, just booping because I'm done fucking with shit.
You done fucking with shit?
Okay. Oh, Shink. How did you over there, Rat Queen?
I know, is Rat Queen back?
Says level 5. I'm checking her, Boop, I'm checking your thing, Rat Queen, just to see if your particular flavor of rogue gets anything at level 5. Nope, you don't get something until level 9 for Soul Knight.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Well, it makes sense because of how fucking powered you are.
You are so powerful, Rat.
But I want to be more powerful.
Oh, it's coming. let's see. Ranger, rogue. Rogue at level 5. You got uncanny dodge. And your sneak attack is 3d6 instead of 2d6 now. Let me just make sure you sneak. Yep, it's 3d6. Jesus. Oh my god, like you needed any more sneak attack. Okay, what does uncanny dodge do again? Starting at 5th level, when an attacker that you can see hits you with an attack, you can use a reaction to halve the attack's damage against you. And that's just a reaction. You can use that as many times as you fucking like. Jesus.
Uncanny dodge. Uncanny dodge says no.
Why did I use that more with Brick?
Yeah, why didn't you?
I've been using that left and right.
Yeah. Every single time. There's no short rest.
To be fair, he almost never got hit.
Yeah.
What's going on?
He was always in the back of the party throwing his brick.
Uncanny dodge is not a once and done, one done like everybody else. Uncanny dodge is literally whenever they want. It's ridiculous.
Oh, goat, if you click anywhere on the screen, you can get rid of that dice that's just hanging out there.
But I like it.
You like it?
It's having fun over there. Look at that. I'm just chilling.
Can't wait till we find a corpse.
Can't wait till you find a corpse? Why would you need a corpse?
That's an odd thing to say you're ready to find.
That's crazy.
I mean, what else am I going to spend my third level spell slots on?
That's a good question.
Like,
yeah, you're a life domain cleric too.
Death.
Oh, death domain, sorry.
Mm-hmm. That's why I'm excited for it.
What happened?
Oh no.
Like, I've got 3 other spells. I've got like 4 third level spells prepared.
Oh.
But I'm only ever gonna have 1 spell slot available for y'all.
Lady is gonna find a severed head and bring it back to life like Prometheus.
Yeah. Like that one guy from Hellboy, yeah.
That was a full-blown body. Well, at least half one.
And then was Prometheus from the, from...
Aliens.
Oh. And then we got the new God of War. You got, you got that head.
Mimir,
yeah. We got ourselves a Mimir. Well, don't you worry. We'll have a little puppet boy walking around.
My question is,
8 hours of a puppet
boy. Why don't they just, you know, nobody's using Odin's body now. It's a perfectly usable body right now. Why not have the kid, Atreus, move his soul into Odin's body? Give him a body. Like, who better than the guy who tied you to a fucking tree?
Goodness.
I don't think he'd want it.
I don't remember the ending, I'm sorry. I didn't get to the ending. Never got to.
To be fair, there'd probably be like a lot of people who would try to kill him first, ask questions later.
Mm-hmm.
And also being fucking Odin, he's a crazy bastard. Fuck him.
No boops. That's like a rude. Oh, I need to fix that.
My question is, where was Sleipnir?
Sleipnir? I don't know. Maybe they'll have it in the next game.
But Odin's dead. There's no point of a 6-legged horse if Odin's dead.
I mean, this may go into the next. I mean,
Egypt's the next one. They've already said.
What did they already say?
The creator's already said he's moving them into he's moving Kratos into with the Egyptian gods.
Oh, that's pretty cool. I like the Egyptian gods. It's pretty good.
I wonder if they're gonna have them be like the original Stargate movie, where their like animal heads are just helmets.
Oh, man, I don't like that. I don't want that. Come on.
But they're such good props.
They were such good props.
I do want the. Maybe it's because it's the furry in me. So, I just want. I want them to have their animal heads.
Well, what, doesn't that make it even more realistic for furries? Wearing god fursuits.
No, fursuits? No. God dare.
Is Shink reading a book tonight?
I don't have any books.
I've got some books.
Oh god. Oh no. Oh no.
Alright, has everybody returned?
Yes.
I am here.
Got Lady. We got Rat Queen.
Mm-hmm.
We got Brawn. We got Heli. And we got Aether. Alrighty. It is now bright and early. Birds are chirping. I believe who said they were on third watch?
I was.
Brawn.
I'm going to need you to give me a perception check. I'm going to have him sleep over here, actually.
He don't know us too well.
Eight. As far as you know, nothing interesting happened in your watch.
Boop, boop, boop. Looking at my book. My cool new book.
Everybody is beginning to wake up and stir. Zesh, as you come to, you notice that Draconis is completely looking like he just got a polish. There's no more signs of rust on him. Everything that was gold is now bright gold. His blade is shimmering silver.
Sparkle, sparkle.
I give him a big hug. I'm so proud of him.
Okay.
It's Lady. You can't question Lady.
He is now considered a stirring.
Oh, what?
He's a soup ladle.
It's an artifact, and most artifacts have 3 to 4 stages. He was a slumbering artifact. He is now stirring.
Oh, okay.
It's actually not most artifacts. There are a good number of them, but about half of them still just have like one thing going for them.
Yeah. But there are many artifacts that do have like 4 stages.
There's even another one in the game you can find somewhere.
Oh my god.
Bum bum.
Bum bum.
Bum bum. Ugh. 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 Goodness gracious. Good morning. Good morning. Morning. Morning, everyone.
Hello.
Morning.
Bad way.
Morning.
Hello.
Hello, everyone. Good morning.
Hello, hello.
Well, how did everyone sleep? Everything all good? Goodness. You're in high spirits today.
What happened?
I was just saying good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, dear friend.
Morning.
Good morning, Zesh.
Good morning,
Bowler. Gotta be something.
I wonder if Leah and and Sheena are awake.
I wonder.
Touch them.
Good morning.
Oh my god.
Don't you worry, I've got some.
Oh my god.
No!
He's back!
This reads one of Zesh's books about a rising mast and heaving chest. Oh,
that's gracious.
I see a mimic book. Ah. Mm-hmm. Book about mimics.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
That's
the that book was. About mimic is a mimic.
Damn. That's deep.
Oh no. It's like the angels from Doctor Who.
The weeping angel.
My goodness. Well, are you all ready and set? Urbix, are you ready?
Basically.
Yes. Shink, are you ready to go? Personally, I would like.
Are you still morning. Focused on that book?
Morning coffee. Oh.
Shink, roll me a d3.
Oh no. Okay.
Just do slash r space 1d3.
And then,
oh, kind of big chest.
Alrighty, you what are reading. Lolth Lavicious Wishes.
Lascivious.
Lascivious, sorry. Words and shit.
Words.
Oh
shit.
My god. Oh no.
She's watching. She's reading pornos.
This is basically Lolth's sexcapades with various other dark gods.
Just like any other romantic book.
about a giant spider lady.
Yeah, doing the dirty with abominations that only the elder gods know.
Beyond your mind's comprehension.
Let's just hope it doesn't have pictures.
It probably do.
Oh no!
Well, you couldn't comprehend them. It's okay. It looks like a jumble of nothing.
I'd be like drawings and shit.
Shink just walks out of her tent still reading.
Shink, what items are you attuned to?
A few. Let me get my notes.
At minimum, the glasses of the night owl. Like the night owl's glasses and the bleeding bouquet.
I thought I was attuned to the brooch too.
Brooch?
Hmm. Yeah.
The
brooch of shielding.
Oh.
Does that shield you from force damage?
It do,
yeah. Alright, so that actually makes her immune to the force damage. She would have seen God from seeing those images.
Oh my god.
Force damage or psychic damage?
It would have been force.
The baby scar. That works, but okay.
Basically reading from a sexy warlock's tome.
I feel like just showing them the pictures and then giving them all force damage.
Oh no, no, don't do that!
Tell me a baby.
Upon seeing Shink with one of my books, I'm gonna ask for it back.
Okay.
You can keep reading tomorrow night. Or next she time we rest.
Helly dum dum. Helly can't read.
What are you talking about? You're smart enough to read. Don't tell it.
If birds
I wanna
could
be
blush.
Dumb enough to not read. It's funny.
If birds could blush.
then Shink would be red.
Well, I see that you are having a lot of fun there. I don't know what that book is, but I'm glad that you guys have been enjoying yourselves.
Does Obix have anything to say about the book that we just passed between each other?
Considering what Obix knows what they are, you just go see him sneer and kind of like turn away. Housewife smut.
Yeah, what of it?
To each their own.
You need help, tiny man?
Which tiny man is she referring to?
Braun.
What?
Okay.
Me?
Of what?
Oh no, I was just saying we should head on out. We're ready to go.
Yeah, where are we going?
Headed up north.
Great, which way's north?
What do you mean? I guess I take out the book.
This way is north. Okay. The book is pointing that way. Which is north.
Oh, good.
Towards
the
spine of the world, like Twirlth originally said.
Yeah.
Although it is still very blurry, the arrow is just barely visible.
Oh, that must mean it's quite far. Lovely.
Nice.
Shall we?
To the spine of the world.
Quite the journey ahead of us.
Let us head forth. And Bron dusts himself off. Puts his bag on and says, "Come along, dear friends." Belly.
Sighing, everybody, their little walking buddies.
Come along.
Aha! I'm not attached to anyone!
I'll keep that in mind.
No!
I just need you walking.
Whatever happened to Bron's bat?
It's around.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, we just aren't keeping track of that token because it's small. And
unless I need it for something, yeah.
Okay.
It just becomes extra work whenever we're not using it.
Yeah.
By the way, when's the last time you fed that thing?
It's a fey creature. It doesn't need food.
I'm pretty sure they do.
I'm pretty sure they'd want food regardless, or they'd start getting a bit extra mischief.
Yeah.
Mischievous.
If you're not gonna feed it, I will.
Well, what about these two? I haven't seen them feed their two pets.
Who?
Helly and Rat.
Mine just became a thing. It wasn't really in. And Rat
has a
little.
Rat has a
mouse.
Yeah.
Rat has a mouse. She's a mouse.
Oh my god.
She's fed her mouse.
I've been feeding my friend.
She keeps her mouse in the same pouch, but she keeps her rat in the
She keeps her mouse in her head.
Oh, in her head?
Yeah.
Just peek out every now and then.
The mouse so eats.
Hey.
Alright. I'm not going.
It's just whisper, like... Does it just whisper shady shit to you?
No.
The mouse?
Stay right.
Yes. Do you want to stay in the back? Or do you want to be in the front?
No, I want
like you're
the
trying
middle.
To get in the front.
Helly, where do you want to go?
Everywhere.
Heck, stop it.
Stop it.
No.
I know! Bye, Bron!
No, I'm just messing with you.
Nice knowing you, Bron.
I love doing that to you.
No.
It's just bronzing night terrors during the day.
Allie's so fast.
Allie just
those little legs are pretty fast.
Allie's so fast.
And ready to go.
You are all now moving past a certain area into what is considered many a party's greatest enemy.
So, like,
the liquor store.
Play it cool.
Let's play it cool.
Liquor store would be
the
good.
The bane of every player's existence. As you're all walking up the road, you come across a crossing. Below it is a rushing white river. And above it is a rickety old wooden bridge.
Oh. This is easy.
So brawny.
The rope bridge, I should say.
No problem. I cast Tensor's floating disc. I'm kidding. We don't know the obstacle yet, so. Well, goodness gracious. It seems there's a bridge. I guess, we go. Who's going up first?
Question.
Hallie can. Hallie's small.
What's the question?
Use giant might. Would I be able to stand in said river and help people across?
That is a good question. Why don't you try?
I'm not sure if that's gonna hold everybody.
I guess I can make an engineering check.
Giant
Spike. Okay, I make a perception check on this bridge.
I don't remember.
I could probably help.
Yeah!
I have the Amanthea.
I fall!
I believe you are 60 feet tall now.
It just says.
Can you link large. It in chat?
Huh? Do I just press the little speed bubble thingy?
Yeah.
Oh, there we go.
Okay.
Oh, this doesn't change your height really all that much. You would just go from being
slightly medium
to being large. You're not much bigger than you already are. I'd say you probably grew like 2 feet.
What about the Amanthea mushroom?
The which one?
Amanthea.
Can you this mushroom that one to me?
Amanita?
Yeah, that thing.
Where did I put that?
That thing.
That's a red cat mushroom.
I thought it had large on it. It was like
Amanita muscaria is literally just a red cat mushroom with little white dots on it.
Yeah, Mario.
Mario.
It's a regular mushroom, like in real life. It's a real mushroom.
Mario mushroom.
I'm not gonna say that's not true. I believe you on that, but.
All right. If Eden produces the effects similar to the enlarged spell, along with immunity, you can either immunity to concussions. Alrighty, enlarge.
Mm-hmm.
The target size doubles in all dimensions. Try what goes from medium to large.
Oh, so it's just the same thing.
It's pretty much the same thing.
But if already large,
they're even bigger.
No, I don't think that's how it works.
He said it doubles your size.
Size
Kelly, medium size.
Kelly wants 5e, huge. So let's see. So it would put her at giant height if she ate that while she was enlarged right now.
Okay, well, I'll give that to Zesh.
Just, all right.
I am not already enlarged.
That would be Aether.
Oh.
I am large size right now because I used my giant might.
I mean, we can make two bigger women. We can make a bigger woman and a bigger man.
It's whatever.
I only have one mushroom.
That's never mind.
I'll give that to Aether then.
Okay. Thank you.
Let us do it.
As much as I would have loved to have taken it, this is not the situation for it.
Yay.
Alright, you may move into the water, Aether. It is considered difficult terrain for you. So you will be slow trudging through it.
Oh, okay.
Alright, whoever's going to cross the bridge first, go ahead.
So I want to help people cross the bridge.
Yeah,
so I want to stand right here.
I'll assume you're giving them the help option as they're crossing.
Yeah. Like holding on to them as they're crossing.
The Shink, give me a dex save with advantage. You pass. You may continue on your way across the bridge.
You good?
Up to the obvious point where it's broken, of course, where you have to make another one.
Oh, heck. Can I walk over there and help that, too?
Give me a strength check.
Me?
Yes.
Well, it gets like, okay.
Because I'm saying the water is probably about waist deep for you at your current position. Getting towards the center will be almost like just below your chest height.
Jeez. Deep river.
Deep and fast. 12, I'll go ahead and say you pass that.
Cool. So I'll go over there. And I help.
Just because of your size. Alright, go ahead and make the dex save with advantage. Shink. Do you note that every time you pass that midsection, Aether will be making that check? Yeah, you pass, even without the...
I got one person across!
You did, in fact, get across, Shink.
The person who probably had the best chances of doing it on their own.
Shink or Obix.
Does Obix
want to
go next?
I think I'm having him go last.
Kaliga wants to go next.
Okay. Do you want help?
Me.
Okay, I'm gonna move my character, then I'll do the roll.
Strength check.
Yeah.
18, yep, you passed.
Yay!
Jesus. You only got +2 to strength. Alrighty, Helly, you may go start your crossing. When you get to this point, give me a dex save with advantage.
Okay.
By the way, Aether, if you did not have inspiration, go ahead and click that for yourself. Unfortunately, with this, Helly, you unfortunately just lose your footing and slip between
some open boards.
Can I catch it?
Aether, yeah, go ahead and give me a dex check. All right, you managed to catch Helly pretty easily.
Goodness. Can I carry her across?
Yes. Give me a strength check with disadvantage.
No!
No, I'm kidding. It's just a normal strength check.
Okay, good. Scared me. No!
Unfortunately, the water is proving to be a bit difficult.
Why is this the one that I failed?
You seem to be doing much in terms of moving. Your option is to either drop Helly in the water or drop her back onto the bridge right here.
Right here. On the bridge!
Alright, Helly, you're back on the bridge.
Where is... okay.
Drop her into the water.
No! It's the rushing river! I'm not sure if anyone can normally walk through this.
Get up to here and give me another dex save.
Would you like help with that dex save?
I'll fall in the water. I'll move somewhere else.
The water! No! No! All right. No!
You're in the water. I need you to give me a athletics check.
Something that I do not have.
Oh no!
Let's see. I believe that's what that is. Okay.
15. Alright, you do manage to swim yourself to shore, just barely.
You scared me.
Hey, though, I have a bit of an idea.
Okay, go ahead.
I was thinking of casting a little spell very quickly before yours run out.
Okay.
This one. And these gang get on top, and then you hold me, and then you just cross, and they'll follow on the floating disc. You'll be on top of the floating disc, completely safe, just following me along with me.
Okay, just a second, let me read it.
Are you casting disc?
Yes.
In mobile wire, it's at 20 feet of it.
In a deep guttural voice. You're counterspell. No, I'm kidding.
God damn it! No!
God damn
it. No, instead you just get bit and he runs away. No.
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 I create a floating disc and I asked for uppies. From Aether.
Okay.
Come along.
If you're within 20 feet of it.
Yeah, it'll just follow.
Alright, I'll put you up on Aether's shoulder.
Okay.
With her arm that's looking like it's holding you up.
Thank you.
It does, kind of.
And then these three will be following along on a floating disc.
The disc is only 3 feet in diameter.
That's fine.
About one person would be able to hang out on it.
Goodness, really?
Really?
What size is Obix?
It's 3 feet.
Well, you could sit in each other's lap.
Obix is small.
You could sit in each other's lap.
Yeah, true. Obix is small. You could sit in somebody's lap if he'd go for that kind of indignation.
Yeah.
Goodness.
Boop hat.
You get hugged. You just get hugged by one boob lady or another boob lady.
Right.
Their boobs.
Which one of us is gonna go first?
I'll leave that up to you.
Oh god, I worry about that.
Take Alea.
Alright, so Aaliyah's on the,
floating disc.
The floating disc.
Okay.
With the
strength check.
Boy.
Are you taking him across as well?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, oh, him? Yeah. At the same time, yeah. You can
makes
hold up
sense.
To 500.
Alright, I'm going to need a strength check from you, Aether, as you try to pass. Let me finish before you start.
Okay.
With a little difficulty, you do manage to get past the deeper water.
Oh, no. Good. Yay. Let's drop you off over here. Ow! Oh, the water!
Ah! Wee!
Come with me! You gotta come with me!
Okay, we'll go.
Consider him with you whenever you move. Don't worry about it. You can't move him yourself.
There you go. And I place you down.
And Obi, and
down you go.
And Aaliyah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, what the hell is happening right now?
They become one.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Alright. There's one. Now Zish.
Yeah.
You gotta give me that check to see if you get back across.
Okay.
Yeah. Alright, you make it across pretty a lot easier before.
And again?
Yeah.
And again. Yeah, you made it across pretty easily. You're getting better at this, you feel.
Hooray.
Yay! Everyone's across. Woohoo!
And there we go.
Yeah!
See, that wasn't hard at all.
We did it!
Yes.
Yay!
Large and in charge Aether took... took control of the situation, I must say. Good job, Aether. Good job, everyone.
I'm always looking for an opportunity to use that one. I love that ability. That's cool.
Good job. I like how me and Heli were just like sitting back watching all that.
Good job.
And Aether. Actually,
you're not too waterlogged, are you?
That's the second time that I have gotten inspiration in any campaign for using Giant's Might. Nice. The first one, we were fighting a boss and they summoned like a swarm of stuff. I used Giant's Might and I lifted the other player above it so that they could hit the boss that was above it. And I got inspiration for that. It was pretty cool.
Like a swarm of bees.
Yeah, I think it was actually a swarm of bees. It was a weird sword that had multiple different things. It was pretty cool.
Silly. Helly's a cutie bean. Are you... You're not too waterlogged, are you, Heli?
Meh.
Meh.
Heli shakes off.
I guess I can cast Druidcraft to clean you off.
Just because I know that it doesn't look like there's a road here, the road is still just following the direction of the bridge.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Shink gives Heli the slightly burnt cookie.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to drop you.
Wait.
I give
actually,
a puff
I didn't
of
drop
wind.
You. I put you back in the thing and you fell through the bridge.
I give
so it wasn't my fault.
Puff of wind to dry off Heli. With my
drink. Yeah. Shink, stop trying to meld into existence.
But it's fine.
Hello, party. It is I.
Shink is a timer to become the next god.
Boop doop. Give me just a second. Good thing I got everything ready for this. Alright, following the road a little further, you all come across a rather odd scene. It appears that there is a tree that has fallen over onto a wagon. There are four individuals under the tree, one of which is under a larger branch that just broke off after it hit the wagon. A priest is standing nearby, looking over the whole thing. Further at the base, though, you see a rather familiar set of robes.
Did he?
Oh my dear
goodness. Did he cause this and then get himself caught in the chaos as well?
We could kill the priest.
No, no,
no. Behave!
She.
I'm glad you can't actually say that. That's all I'm saying.
As you all approach, the priest is going to look over at you all. Ah, travelers. I am trying to figure out what exactly happened here.
Well, we recognize
the style
of the robes on this person. They've been causing a lot of problems.
I assume he somehow made the tree fall over onto himself while trying to crush the individuals in this cart. Or there were more than one of him and he just happened to get caught in it.
Yeah, they don't tend to care much about their own.
Such wanton deaths for no reason.
Yes, agreed. Dastardly villains, all of them.
Can I make a religion check to see if I know who this man is in service of?
Sure, go ahead. His rosary is in full view. Religion check does fail, unfortunately.
Dang.
You can also just ask.
Fair.
It's proper manners to give your name first. Just saying. Just saying, that's how it goes with everything.
My name is Zesh. I'm a cleric in service of the Lich Mother.
Oh, I don't believe I'm familiar with her.
Most people aren't.
Oh, he actually got a 17. I do think I've read a little bit, but not quite as much as I'd like to. I don't tend to spend too much time studying other religions aside from my own.
Makes sense.
It is interesting to learn the different views of each religion, though.
Quite. I am Nicholas, Father Nicholas, if you would. I am in service of the god Angorod. Fuck, I don't know how to spell this. How do you pronounce this fucking shit?
His name's Nicholas, he's gotta be hot. That's all I'm saying.
I knew Nicholas and his... He was cute, oh. But his attitude...
That is his god's name.
Wow.
His attitude.
It's oh my god for now.
Nope.
Angorod. Okay. You know, is it Angorod or Angorod?
I'm about to find out. Pronounce control V. Pronounce Angorath. Angorath.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense. Sure.
Yeah, sure. That's how you spell that.
Angorath.
Welcome to my world,
also referred to as the Queen of Arvandor, who is sometimes considered the personification of three separate elven goddesses.
Elves?
Hmm.
Yeah. The individual before you is, in fact, an elf.
I don't say it to him. He didn't hear none of that. That's all in my head.
I'm just going to go ahead and show everybody.
Oh my god, he is hot.
I'm just saying. No one would know.
He's okay. Oh, no way!
Rat, no.
No.
I don't want to start religion wars.
No, don't kill him, he's hot. You can't kill hot people.
Yes, you can. You can easily kill hot people, but you shouldn't. It's the answer of you shouldn't, not that.
You should kill anyone, no matter what they look like.
Yeah. It has no. It doesn't matter.
We know. Holly just sits there and pets his jacket because she's very curious in what material it's made out of.
He looks like an anime character.
She's just gonna touch people without permission. She doesn't care.
What anime is he from?
Yeah, what anime is he from?
You know what? I think he'd be a great character in my
opinion. He is going to pull out a small scroll, and he is going to open it and speak very softly as the scroll kind of burns away in a greenish flame before disappearing. You're going to see as the eyes on the corpse of the cultist slowly open, and he is going to lean over it and ask, "Who are you?" The corpse is going to answer, "I am Andorra from Daggerford." He is going to ask, "Why have you done this?" And the corpse will answer, "For the glory of this unpure world, that Tiamat may cleanse it." "How many of you were there?" "Six."
"I want to loot."
"Why are you here?" "We were traveling and followed this caravan. The priest, he called for us."
"Nicholas?"
Nicholas is going to look over at you.
"Would you mind if I asked a question?"
"I can only ask him one more before the spell ends." What is your question?"
I'd like to know where we can find more of them."
He'll look at the corpse. "What is the name of this priest?" "Bordred." "Ah." And he'll look over his Esh. "I know where Bordred is."
"Lucky."
With that, the corpse will go back to being lifeless as the spell Speak with the Dead ends. That still didn't answer my question of how they managed to get the tree over. It's a shame it only lets you ask five.
It is.
Interesting spell.
You got some rather good answers out of him, though. They tend to be less helpful.
Oh, with the Speak with the Dead spell, they typically don't have a choice but to answer them. It's not technically themselves that are answering. The soul has nothing to do with it.
Yes, but they usually aren't as clear.
Have you asked any of them that were already dead?
No.
They're just less helpful when alive.
Out of character, this is me just poking fun at how the spell description mentions that the answers don't have to be very clear at all. They can be as cryptic and bullshit as you.
Oh, I went with cryptic and bullshit as well in there.
Yeah.
He didn't straight up answer every question.
It's a very handy spell, but, and they are forced to answer, but that doesn't mean the answers are good.
That is correct. I usually go by how well the question is asked.
Yeah.
Alrighty. Well then, Wondred is a head priest at a nearby church over in Womford. I believe I should go check that out.
This mm-hmm. place? Is that where I think it is? I don't remember the name of the place.
Can they just hear, like, Aether's voice?
What?
There's books and scrolls in here. You want to come look?
What?
What
is it? That
was me! I swear! Go ahead and roll me a investigation, Shink.
So you actually think that I said that?
Looking through what you can find underneath the tree and the smashed remains of the wagon, you do see a chest. However, the lock has already been broken and its contents removed.
The other five. I assume they were after whoever it was.
Although you do find three sets of commoner clothes.
I wonder why. I wonder where you could have gotten those. Oh, why are these corpses naked?
Fret not, it's those are extra clothes.
It's like Skyrim shit.
People generally tend to carry around more than one set.
I don't know what you're talking about. This is totally Skyrim.
Well, I'm taking them.
As a player who has found corpses after earning a new toy.
They're dead. I don't need them anymore.
I've learned to animate dead.
Oh. Please don't.
Oh, not the villagers. Absolutely not the villagers. They're good people. For now, I'd just like to try and go through the pockets of the culty boy.
Give me a d12. Alright, we got a 7. Have we gotten a 7 yet?
I don't know.
Oh, yes, you have. You find a stick of white chalk for writing and marking various surfaces.
Oh, lovely. I've got a bunch of that.
You should give it to Helly. Helly will eat it.
No.
Oh, wait. I am mistaken. It is not going to be a d12. It is going to be a d6 for this gentleman.
Okay.
Right, 2. Sorry about that. You are going to find a dagger. A ceremonial dagger that is encrusted with gems and has a curved blade with a skull on the hilt.
Damn. Terrifying. Spooky.
It doesn't have any special modifiers, it's just a dagger.
Fancy, pretty little dagger.
Just a really well-made one with a skull on the hilt.
Very spooky.
That's his pickleball.
Spooky.
Look, it's pickleball.
How badly is this man pinned under the tree?
Pretty much the entire lower section is pinched off underneath it.
I assume he's just crushed.
Yeah, his rib cage is concave.
I'm gonna poke him with the blunt end of Draconis Mortis and say, "Aw, this boy's useless."
Poking him with the blunt end of Draconis Mortis will cause his mask to shatter and spill off.
Ooh, that's new.
A little bit suspicious.
Huh? Quite weird. And with that, Father is actually going to begin walking.
Yes.
Good day, nice young Kenku.
Meeting you.
Have a good one.
Y'all want to follow him?
Yeah, we can follow him. Of course we can follow him.
Why not?
You'll actually see him pause in the middle of the road before he turns and looks at you all, looking around at you. I wonder if there might be more of these individuals that a little backup might be required. I'd be willing to offer a reward.
Sink nods.
We like. No, we are so
gladly help.
So we wouldn't mind helping out, you know, a little bit. For a little bit of coin.
Right. They've been causing a lot of problems lately. We'll be glad to help.
We run into them anyways.
Smash cultist skulls. Okay.
Makes sense. Hey, we're doing the same thing. Hasn't changed your plans.
Maybe I'll find something more useful than that poor soul trapped under the tree.
Well, one can help.
That's fair. Alright, that's ominous. Maybe I'll find something. Myself, I'm looking for a,
perhaps I will find a shiny rock.
Non-magical item.
Continuing walking, you find yourselves at the village of Wormford.
What's that fun to say?
The village of Wormford.
Hey, it's Carla! Moment. Yo, I don't know who Carla is.
I don't know.
Well, I'm referring to the wife, girlfriend. I'm not really sure what the relationship is of one of my friends. My name is Carla.
Oh, that's cool.
It's Carla's house.
And I need to grab this. Hold on just a second as I'm grabbing tokens and stuff.
Oven, that's one big oven.
I just need to find a non-magical item.
This is a supply store.
There we go.
I assume that's
party
a store,
token is down there in the corner.
Party! Whoop whoop! Do we want to go to the supply place? Was it a store?
Torrega Supplies is in fact a store.
Okay, do we want to go there really quick?
Up to you.
Bron said that he would like to find some non-magical items or something.
I mean,
and I think it'd be a good place to find something because it is a supply store. Well, it's bound to have something.
Yeah. Yes. I agree with Apa.
Okay, my PNG tube is getting on my nerves.
Oh no. I'm sorry.
So I have this. I have the sensitivity up at a certain spot, so whenever I'm talking, it won't. It'll just keep bouncing back and forth. Because it's set to a weird sensitivity level.
There we go.
Oh, that's the best I can do. I can't do much else.
And we're here.
Nice.
It's about to be one.
Wait, which one is it? Wait, is it?
How much longer are you allowed to be up, bud?
Well, I gotta go to work at 7:45.
Alright, so we're probably going to end it pretty soon then, like, probably when you guys are done with the general store.
Aw, me? Okay.
Right, at the general store, you're going to be able to find pretty much all general adventuring necessities. Glass bottles, blankets, bedrolls, backpacks, arrows, crossbow bolts, chain, rope, kits, clothes, crowbars.
Hey, What is a tiny object in D&D?
Helly's
no,
tiny
no,
object.
No, 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 you're small. No, no, no.
Rations. Rope, the rope is either hempen or silk.
Do we need anything? I feel like rope would be convenient to have. We have rope. Do we have rope?
I think we have, like... Many of the starting equipment come with rope. Not all of them, though.
Yeah. Hempen rope. I have one of those.
Let's see. Well, I would say,
and fishing tackle.
That's all I'm looking for is a tiny object.
Well, we've got soap, we've got vials, we've got sacks and pouches, we've got pots and pans.
I mean, what do you guys
locks see? And lanterns.
Well, I guess a lantern wouldn't be bad. A tiny lantern, then.
Alright, do you want a regular lamp or a hooded lantern?
A hooded lantern would be fine. What?
That'll be 5 gold pieces.
5 gold? Jeez. Okay, not a problem.
Why do you want the hooded lantern?
You will see in just a moment, my dear friend.
Yes, okay.
I wasn't saying that in character.
Oh. Why do I want it? Oh, it's because I have a new spell, and it's 8-hour duration.
Subtract 5 gold pieces and add 1 hooded lantern to your inventory.
Nice. -5.
We've also got mirrors.
Ooh, I would take a mirror.
Right, that's another 5 gold.
Bird just wants to look at it. Look at itself.
And a fishing tackle.
And fishing tackle.
And like a line. Calligraphy.
Okay.
Fishing tackle is 1 gold piece.
Okay, so 6 gold pieces.
Yeah, that'll be 6 total.
One a mirror and.
Okay. Unfortunately, this particular store does not have calligrapher tools.
Dang. I do need that eventually.
I have picked up a mirror.
We got a bird. Can't we just ask the bird for a feather and make it into a quill?
Well, it's a lot more than just a quill.
It does sell parchment, though.
I could buy some parchment. Could I make my own calligraphy kit?
It also does have ink and ink pen.
Okay. I guess I could make my own.
Ink is 10 gold pieces.
Oh, dang.
An ink pen is 2 copper pieces. And paper is 2 silver pieces, while parchment is 1 silver piece.
So is that a calligraphy set, or do I need a little
bit? It is not a calligraphy set.
Well, then, what?
I was just telling you what the prices were.
Yeah, I know, but I need a calligraphy set. It's specific about it.
Yes, I know. Unfortunately, this particular seller just doesn't have those.
Did Zesh want the choker then, or no?
It's all in a calligraphy set. Let
me look. Sure. I'll take it.
Okay, it's a silver spider choker. That's what it says it is.
Okie dokie.
All right, that reminds me. Roll me a d6, Zesh.
What?
Okay.
I didn't think it was cursed.
Oh no, it's nothing that you're giving her that's cursed. Or. Oh. All right, Zesh, you are, again, you feel a small pinprick on your shoulder as you're bit by a small spider.
God damn it.
Oh, lovely.
Go ahead and take 2 damage, piercing.
I'm sorry.
It is not because of the choker.
I have taken 2 piercing damage.
Oh my dear goodness.
I will say, though, Zesh, you are currently cursed.
Okay. Oh.
That's okay.
Just give me a moment.
Would you like to roll a history check?
Sure.
History. All right, that's pretty good one. I'll go ahead and give that to you. You remember at some point finding a small brooch on one of the drow that you killed. These small spider bites didn't start happening until after you touched that.
Wow. That's unfortunate.
Am I really gonna do this early? Do I know what the curse is?
The curse is being attacked by spiders occasionally.
Occasional annoyance by spiders.
Hold on. Actually, before I do this, I'm gonna check if I've been carrying that shit.
It doesn't matter if you've been carrying it or not. I'll tell you right now.
I guess as soon as you touch it,
I just want to make sure I don't get cursed again.
Oh, no, it's only good for one curse.
No, yeah, I am still carrying it, but yeah. I'm just...
I would say probably wait till after this next part's done before you start trying to use spell slots.
Okay.
Yeah.
I did pick up remove curse.
Opix is going to buy himself some extra rations. He's going to buy in total 6.
Good job. Good job, old man.
What are you calling old?
It's just a saying, my friend.
Who you calling friend?
You, my dear pal.
We call him pal guy.
Oh, you're my guy, of course.
I'm not your guy friend.
Oh, friend. I could go with that. No! Yeah. I'm
not your friend, buddy.
So we're buddies now? That's pretty cool.
Oh, God.
Somebody doesn't watch the South Park.
No, Bron doesn't watch it. I know the joke.
Zesh smacks Bron.
Bitch, shut up!
So, yeah, that's 3 gold pieces from Obix for the rations.
I can cast that spell now or later. It doesn't matter. It's going to be a 10-minute wait. But the Hooded Lantern now has legs and arms.
Oh, well, lovely. Okay.
And now he's following this around.
Can I pet it? I want to pet it.
Yeah, you can pet him. He's pretty chill.
Pet.
Father Nicholas is just waiting for you all. Being very polite.
Did he see me pet the lantern?
Yes, he's definitely seeing you pet the lantern.
Here you go. Here's the tiny person.
So cute! Tiny lantern, can you draw
he's
the tiny lantern?
15 okay. Natural armor.
Yeah, he's fucking, he's beefy, boyo.
That's a lot for a fucking lantern.
It says any tiny object, so I'm like, okay. Alright, fine, the Hooded Lantern. Now it's just...
He has a hat.
You can give him a little hat if you want.
Don't pet him.
He's got little noodle arms, I'm guessing. He's like...
Look at all those immunities, so...
He's fucking...
Okay, so...
He's immune to psychic damage. She can't do shit to him with his psychic damage.
By the way, it's official. It's not just me. This is official spell.
I know it's official, so...
Okay, so I'm going to...
At least it's on the floor in front of the lantern.
I want you to draw him.
You want me to draw him? Okay.
Yeah, I'm gonna do a 20-minute sketch. Right. All right, I want you to draw the little sentient lantern.
The Hooded Lantern waves and looks around, just confused.
I just imagine it's like just got its hands on its would-be lantern hip, just looking all proud of itself and looking around.
You know, looking around with air quotes because it doesn't have eyes.
It's using that one circular hooded lantern hole.
Yep.
Kelly sits in front of it and just pokes it.
What? Wee!
Oh. Wee!
Wee! It does jazz hands. Starts doing a little tap dance.
Kelly baps it and then gets
hello,
up.
Hello, my baby! Hello, my honey!
Hello, my baby! Hello, my honey! Hello, my ragtime gal!
Kelly does not like the lantern dance.
Okay. No. It doesn't do that. It just waves. It just waves and does. Just is being cute. Made adorable.
I want you to draw Aether petting the lantern. Yeah. I put that in the thing.
I don't know what to name it. I'm going to keep casting this spell daily. Why wouldn't I? It's,
very cute.
Pretty cool.
I just imagine he
brings
out
her paints and starts painting a face on it.
Oh no.
Yeah, if you need a picture of a hooded lantern, there are tons of them.
Yeah, so, it's, yeah, and also I don't have the concentrate, which is the funniest part. It's like, what the fuck is up with that?
Hallie's just gonna paint a face on it.
Yeah, alright. Paint a face on him. I don't care. Braun does not care.
Oh my gosh, drawing like an uwu face on him.
That's what it's gonna be.
Oh my gosh.
Whiskers and cat ears and everything.
Oh my gosh.
I love it.
Alright, and with that, I think we're gonna call it for the night.
Yee. I cry
because it's a tiny lantern.
I cry.
Name him Mochi.
No crying.
Name him what?
Mochi, since I made him look like a cat.
that would be good though.
How long are you going, Tara?
I don't know. I was thinking about ending it here. Let me see. Let me check.
If anything,
okay, give me a second.
I believe Kelta just started not too long ago.
Yeah, well, I could always send you guys to Kelta.
Let me see who's on.
He's been going for 2 hours. He's probably going to keep going for a while.
Yeah, I can send you over to him. It's all good.
I can hang out with Juju.
Yeah. I'm sorry, I've got work tomorrow, gang. So I do apologize.
It's all good. Wait a minute. Okay, I need to look up what a hooded lantern looks like. Because I've had a thing.
Okay.
But I need to look it up first.
You got a thing?
Images.
Freaking Kelto's
noise. Oh my god! Okay, so I've got a thing. Oh, you're right. So go look at my stream.
Alright. I shall look at your stream.
There we go. My emote.
Oh, I see.
I love lamp emote.
I love lamp.
I love empiric lichen.
I love. Cute. Very cute. Yeah, well, then we love lamp. We love lamp even more.
Yeah. Love lamp. Oh my gosh. I just looked up hooded lantern and a whole bunch of stuff popped up. I clicked on images and a bunch of stuff popped up.
Yeah, lots of stuff come up, don't they?
That is... Not
probably best way to specify hooded lantern 5e.
Jesus. Okay.
I sent you the link to that, by the way.
Well, I looked it up on Google on my phone. That's so loud.